In today's video, we are going to be comparing three insulin resistance treatments and going over the pros and the cons of each. Insulin resistance is when the body is not able to efficiently manage blood sugar, leading to high insulin levels. And these high insulin levels cause symptoms such as visceral or abdominal fat, skin tags, dark skin patches, and irregular periods for women. On top of that, high circulating insulin levels will eventually lead to more serious conditions, including type 2 diabetes and PCOS. Three treatments often prescribed to those with insulin resistance, type 2 diabetes, and PCOS include metformin, berberine, and inositol. So in today's video, we are going to be comparing these three treatment methods, talking about their effectiveness, and also the associated side effects. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform that does it all. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. So in today's video, we are going to be discussing three treatments for insulin resistance. One of these treatments, metformin, is a drug, and the other two, berberine and inositol, are naturally occurring substances found in food that can be concentrated into supplements. All three have been promoted as effective treatments for insulin resistance, type 2 diabetes, and PCOS. But are they all equally effective? And are they all safe? We're going to answer these questions and more in today's video. Metformin. We're going to start off today talking about metformin. As of 2018, metformin is the fourth most prescribed drug in the United States, with over 120 million people prescribed it worldwide. Metformin, also known by the brand name Glucophage, is an oral drug that requires a prescription. It improves how your body responds to insulin by helping your cells to accept sugar more efficiently, reducing the levels in your bloodstream. Metformin also decreases sugar absorption through your intestines, meaning that less sugar makes it into your bloodstream in the first place. And it also reduces the amount of sugar your liver releases into your blood, once again, helping to control blood sugar. Metformin is also promoted for its anti-aging and disease prevention benefits. And you might be thinking to yourself, wow, metformin kind of sounds like a super drug. But unfortunately, there is a catch. There is a long list of side effects caused by metformin, including bloating, fatigue, gas, diarrhea, low testosterone, vitamin and mineral deficiencies, hair loss, muscle pain, brain fog, hypoglycemia or low blood sugar, and tingling palms and feet. And in some cases, it can cause anemia and lactic acidosis. Anemia is when your blood doesn't have enough healthy red blood cells. In this situation, anemia is caused by very low vitamin B12 because metformin depletes this vitamin. And anemia leads to reduced oxygen flow to the body's organs. The results of anemia can be severe, so making sure you are getting enough vitamin B12 in through your diet if you are taking metformin is critical. Lactic acidosis occurs when metformin causes a buildup of lactic acid in the bloodstream. And if your body is not clearing it properly, this can lead to very serious problems. If you have any kidney problems or consume excessive amounts of alcohol, you are at a greater risk. If not treated, lactic acidosis can lead to a coma or death. This side effect is rare, but I think it's important to note. That being said, these side effects can be minimized. Taking metformin with food, supplementing the vitamins and minerals that metformin depletes, increasing your dose of metformin slowly, or taking the extended release version instead can all help. And speaking of which, metformin comes in both immediate release and slow release options. The initial dose for immediate release is usually 500 milligrams twice a day, or 850 milligrams once a day. The initial dose for slow release is usually 500 to 1,000 milligrams once a day. Berberine. Berberine is a chemical that is extracted from certain plants, such as turmeric. It has been shown in numerous studies to aid in weight loss and lower blood sugar, and it does this by improving insulin resistance. It works in a lot of the same ways that metformin does. It makes insulin more effective, so your cells accept more blood sugar. It decreases the amount of sugar that your liver releases. And it slows down the breakdown of carbohydrates in the gut. A 2012 review that looked at 14 studies found berberine to be just as effective as metformin for the treatment of type 2 diabetes. However, a lot of digestive side effects that are seen with metformin are also seen with berberine. This includes constipation, gas, and diarrhea. Berberine is commonly taken 3 times a day before meals, 500 milligrams at a time. While berberine is considered to be very safe, it is also not recommended to take it for more than 6 months at a time. Now, before we get into the final insulin resistance treatment that we're going to talk about today, I'm going to take a quick moment to tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform for all of your online needs. Whether you run a business, are starting a side hustle, or need a website for personal use, Squarespace has everything you need all on one platform. Long gone are the days of hosting your website on one platform, your email list on another one, your payment platform on another one, and your scheduling app on yet another one. And don't even get me started on trying to connect them all. Squarespace makes your life easy by having all of these features and more in one place. Not only is Squarespace practical and easy to use, it also allows you to create a clean and professional website without needing any experience in web design. Their award-winning templates are customizable, and with only a few clicks, you can have the website of your dreams that aligns with your brand. You can start a free trial and build your whole website without having to enter your credit card details or anything by heading to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate. And when you build your website and you love it, you can use code healthcoachkate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. I know, Sital. And the last insulin resistance treatment we're going to be talking about today is inositol, also known as myo-inositol. Inositol is a naturally occurring substance found in foods such as citrus fruits, but the human body can also synthesize it. Because the body can synthesize it, it is considered to be a non-essential nutrient. Essential nutrients are those that we need to get through our diet because our body can't make them, or can't make enough. An example of this is omega-3. But since the body can make inositol, it is considered to be non-essential. However, a lot of people do not synthesize inositol well, and there are several reasons why it can become depleted. And this is why it is also isolated into a supplement. The average person consumes about 1 gram of inositol every day through their diet, but studies have been done looking at much higher doses, up to 18 grams. And once again, inositol improves insulin sensitivity and can help to reverse insulin resistance. It does this by improving the cell's ability to accept glucose and also the body's ability to burn fat for energy. A 2017 study done on type 1 diabetics found that inositol helped patients to better control their blood sugar. Usually, inositol is paired with a folic acid supplement. There have also been studies done on women with gestational diabetes and PCOS, who saw improvements in blood sugar and other symptoms while supplementing inositol and folic acid. As for side effects, it can cause a lot of similar digestive side effects as we already spoke about with metformin and berberine, especially when taken in large doses above 12 grams per day. It can also cause difficulty sleeping, headaches, and fatigue, again, especially at these high doses. And it is also important to note that there have been no long-term studies done on inositol, so it is unclear whether it is safe long-term. Like berberine, inositol can also be bought over-the-counter as a supplement. The dosage recommended for inositol can vary greatly, but even as little as 2 grams per day can be beneficial. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. I didn't want to give too much of my opinion in this video. I more so just wanted to provide you with the facts, give you the relevant information, and let you come to your own conclusions about which, if any, might be suitable for you. Of course, there are other ways to improve insulin sensitivity and reverse insulin resistance that do not require a drug or supplement. I have another video that goes over 3 lifestyle changes you can make that are really easy that can help you to reverse insulin resistance. I will link that video above if you want to check it out and learn more about that. I have got so many messages and comments from people who implemented the tips that I spoke about in that video, who were actually able to stop taking their metformin eventually because they no longer needed it. I'm not saying for anyone to stop taking any prescribed drugs, but it's just something to consider that you might not always need it. Anyways, let me know in the comment section down below if you have tried any of these treatment methods and what your experience was. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and click that subscribe button if you're not already. I post 2 new videos every week. And also remember to check out today's sponsor, Squarespace. And you can do that by heading to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate. Thanks again, guys, for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy my video on how to lower blood sugar fast. You can check that video out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find those here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.